Hi, I'm Nick from Australia Native Bee. Today's video is on John Klumpp solitary bee hotels. If you've ever wanted to build a bee hotel yourself, turn the subtitles on and listen to what John has to say, because he's been doing this for absolutely years.
I used to have thousands and thousands of blue banded bees. When they were doing the research on using blue banded bees for pollination, I got really interested, and I built these concrete and bloody rammed earth blocks and everything, and I had thousands of blue banded bees. But over the years they've declined and disappeared. The reason is they don't like to nest in the same holes year after year, because they suffer from chalk brood.
Oh, do they?
And so you have to keep adding new blocks if you want to keep going with blue banded bees. Ways they could use them for greenhouse pollination. And after the blue banded bees sort of abandoned the holes, the
three rows of three, and the other holes, I do it as a decoy, you know, to get them to go in, and the rest of them made drilling. See, if you look at those ones up the top, you can see the amount of excavation by what's falling down in piles out in front of the holes.
Yeah, wow. And these are plaster blocks. And if you look here, the blue banded bees didn't like them all that much. Some of them used them, but not many.
But the resin bees, they excavate them again, and this is all resinous stuff that they've dug out from last year. They must use them over and over again. I have opened them, but you sort of break them when you open them, because the resin bees really stick them shut. And you can find several, I've got photos of several pupae and larvae in there. There's an old bit of the stuff that's fallen out of one of the blocks. You can see all the mortar mixes. Some of these are over there will be rammed earth. These are all rammed earth.
So you just go and find a place.
I try different mediums to try to find what they. I was looking for something that you could use that they would nest in readily in, say, greenhouses and so forth, and try to cut the weight down. And that stuff up the top is that lightweight concrete I use. It's quite lightweight. See those there? And they wouldn't use it for a while, but I noticed they're using it now. In fact, while you were filming there, there was several blue banded bees going in there. So they're obviously starting to use it now.
Interesting. Oh yeah, there's one.
And they started off in some blocks that they really liked, like these. There's nothing left of them now. They've just excavated to the point where everything is just broken down. They don't go back into them then.
What was that made out of?
They're just rammed earth.
Rammed
earth. It was a particular type of earth that they liked, you know?
Yeah.
And they just took to it, you know? Blue banded bees pupae into them, because I had heaps of pupae. Put the blue banded bee pupae into there. And for a while they used them a bit, but they weren't real keen on them. They liked to dig their own holes. Plaster blocks, they're plaster blocks with actual. What I did was like little tubes have been taken over, some of it by wasps, of course.
It's interesting, some of these got a lighter colour.
Mm.
Are they all resin bees?
No, there'd be a lot of wasps in there. But they're rather fascinating.
So that's a proper.
That's a proper. It's made for carder bees, I think they call them. Carder, C-A-R-D. They use them for pollinating lucerne.
Hmm.
And they've introduced them into Australia too.
So I wonder, why doesn't this bee like the resin bees?
I think they're fairly specific on the bees that they parasitise. It's probably a similar body size, or maybe the resin that the resin bees use for their homes is designed as a defence against